Let us see if we have more Muslims calling or trying to call. Let us see. Okay, all right. I'm trying to find if we have any Muslims. We have the guy who called me from yesterday. If I show you what he is saying to me, you will laugh. Let me show you what this guy is saying. How dare you? How dare you convert a Muslim? Debate me right now. You cannot accept cause. You cannot debate me. I destroyed you last time. Admit it. Let us call this a cute one. All right, my friend. Hello?
Hello? Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, you are the one who destroyed me last time, right?
Yeah.
You know what? Since yesterday, I have bruises all over my body because of you. I cannot believe it. So, you know, tell me what do you want me to say? What do you like to say? What do you think?
Listen, I'm No. Listen. You deconverted somebody from the religion of Islam. Do you know what you've done, brother? You have made him into hellfire. You are responsible for somebody sent to hell.
But the Quran says you will go to hell anyway. Isn't it the Quran says wa ma minkum illa
wariduha? No. Brother, listen. If somebody commits shirk, if somebody commits sin, do you know what happens?
What
you happened? Do prayers, you do fasting, you do Ramadan, and you get forgiven.
Ah, okay. But you know, listen. But isn't it Allah, he says, Allah don't forgive those who commit shirk? So how if you do Ramadan, you will be forgiven?
You made that up. You're making up verses. You're making up verses on the spot.
No, I am not. You know?
Alhamdulillah.
No, I did not. You know, the Quran says Allah.
I'm calling for guidance. Okay, I'm calling for guidance of Allah.
Okay, read with me. Chapter 4, verse number 48. Go ahead.
That's Arabic. I can't read Arabic.
No Arabic. English.
Brother, I cannot read Arabic.
My friend, it's in English.
Brother, I cannot read Arabic.
Read in English. You don't know
brother,
Arabic.
Brother, I do not know Arabic.
Chapter 4, verse number 48.
Chapter 4, verse number 48. Let me read this. Sunan Nasiya. Allah did not forgive associating others with him.
Okay, so...
Yeah, he never committed shirk. He never believed in Jesus Christ as God.
But this is mean all the companions of Muhammad, they will not go to heaven, they will go to hell, because all of them, they used to do shirk. Abu Bakr, Umar.
No. Brother. Do not. No. Now you corrupting the Quran. No. You're laughing.
Yeah. Abdul, listen.
You corrupting the Quran.
Abdul. Okay. Who was the first Muslim? Who was the first Muslim in Mecca? Who was the first Muslim? Give me the name.
I don't know.
Muhammad, isn't Muhammad the first Muslim? He's a prophet.
Muhammad is not the first Muslim. No. Muhammad is not the first Muslim. The first Muslim is Abraham. Abraham was the first Muslim.
Okay. So, okay. Let us go to the Quran then.
Reading the Quran. You do not understand the Quran.
Did Abraham came to Mecca?
Yes.
Okay. And so Muhammad is not the first one who came to Mecca, correct?
No. Correct.
Okay. All right, let us see what the Quran said. Because as I know, you are wrong about this. According to the Quran, it says, can you give me like a week to find the verses?
No. You find out. No. You find the verse now.
Okay. But I need some time, you know, like I'm looking right now, I cannot find it. So what do you think what we will do
you
now?
You can find it. Look for it. Look, I will look it up. I will search it.
Okay.
Abraham went to Mecca. I searched this.
Okay. The 2 weeks is over. Chapter 43, verse number 23.
Alhamdulillah. Allah give me guidance in this debate. Oh, wait.
It says what? It
you
says,
don't have God on your side.
Hold on. It says here in this verse, it says that Allah sent Abraham to destroy the town, or he was the good guy?
Abraham came to destroy the pagan statues and stuff.
Okay. So when Abraham, he came to Mecca, the people, they said to Abraham,
yeah,
that you are a bad person. The verse saying that, like each time we send a messenger, a warner to people, you know, the rich one or the bad one, they say to him, we are following the religion before us. Who was living in Mecca when Abraham came?
What?
Who was living in Mecca when Abraham came?
The pagan people.
So there was pagan in Mecca before Abraham?
Yes.
They are mushrikeen, correct?
Yes.
But you just said, I just showed you that Allah forgive not, shirk. So if Abraham come in to guide them to worship Allah, and Allah forgive not those who did shirk, so what the point of sending Abraham?
Well, Abraham had to fulfill his mission.
Yeah, but anyway, Allah will not forgive them anyway. So what the
point? No. Listen, no. Listen. The rule against shirk came after Abraham, not before him.
But you just said there was people was in Mecca before Abraham and they were mushrikeen.
Yes.
So, okay, so Abraham, he come to them and he says to them, I am here to guide you to Allah. But the Quran says, I'm not going to forgive them. So what the point of sending Abraham or Muhammad?
That's a miracle of Allah.
But miracle, he said he will not forgive them in the same time.
He will. No. He said he forgive after that. He made a new rule.
All right. You said Abraham is the first one to come to Mecca or Adam?
Oh, no, Adam never went to Mecca. Adam never went to Mecca.
Number two is what? Abraham?
Yeah, Abraham is one. Adam never went to Mecca.
No, according to Muslims, Adam is the one who built the Kaaba.
No, Abraham built the Kaaba.
No, Abraham...
Who told you that?
Abraham, he left up the Kaaba because after the flood, it was destroyed.
He built the second one.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So now we agree, me and you, that Adam and Abraham and Isaac, Ishmael, they were there. Okay, but here, chapter 34, verse number 44, it says, there's nobody came to Mecca before Muhammad.
I don't know, where is it? Show it. You lie.
Chapter 34, don't shout, otherwise I will hang up on you. Chapter 34, verse number 44.
Well, put it up. I don't see it.
It's in the screen.
What verse again?
Chapter 34, verse number 44.
Okay. Let me read it real quick. Let me get my Quran. It says, they say, so even though we have never given any scriptures to study, nor did, we even sent a warner before you, O prophet.
Okay. So how you Muslim, you say, is Abraham was there, Adam was there, Ishmael was there, and then the Quran says, we never sent to them a book or a messenger before you.
I don't really understand.
Well, you know.
I don't get it.
Okay, no problem. When you understand, you let me know. Okay. Muslims, they claim that Allah, he sent Adam, he sent Abraham, he sent Ishmael to Mecca. In the same time, he say, people of Mecca, they never receive a book before, neither a messenger before. So how that can be? Any Muslim would like to call? The reason I, you know, hang up on him, he shouts, you know, he's just like, I don't know, weirdo. Do we have any Muslim? Who is a Muslim can tell us how this contradiction can happen? If you say that Muhammad is the first messenger to the Arab, but don't you say Muslims that Ishmael is the father of the Arab? And don't you say that Muhammad is from Ishmael? See, your lies is working against you. If Ishmael is the father, grandfather of Muhammad, that means yes, they have a prophet from the Arab. And when Ishmael, he came, and he is a messenger of Allah, shouldn't he have a book? What, he came with what, some tomato, potato in his hand? What the name of the book? Any Muslim knows what the name of the book? Because every prophet have a book or a messenger. So if he is a messenger, then he have a book. Because he have a message. The message of God is the book of God. Do we have any Muslim would like to call us? Yeah, we hang up on him. He said, scared of debating me. For sure, I'm scared of debating you. Who is a Muslim? He have a long beard. He have a strong knowledge. He like to show people that this guy do not know much. I don't know. I'm giving you the chance to prove me wrong. A spiritual journey. How you can take a spiritual journey over a donkey? That is not a spiritual no more. This is physical. All of us, we Arab, we go to the moon every day over donkeys. You know, if you listen to Arab people stories, you will see how many times they fly a day to the seven heaven. All their stories are fabricated. All our history is a fabrication. All of it. So do we have any Muslim would like to call us? Maybe, maybe. A Muslim is saying to me, fork you. Thank you, Muslim. Yeah. Why? Are you a homo? I mean, okay, you say fork you. How a Muslim here is going to fork a man? You remind me about this hadith, Mr. Muslim. In the hadith it says that a bunch of Muslims, they came to complain to the caliphate. About what? That there is a man who is effeminate, gay, and he is tempting them when he bend over. Read the hadith with me. Listen to this. And here you see how corrupt this society is. So they come to the caliphate, and this is Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith number 695. And they said to him, oh, we have a leader. He is a leader of fitna, a trial, affliction, etc. Oh, all of this, what happened? What he's doing? Leader of affliction, fitna, temptation, what is that? And we are afraid of being sinful following him. If, what happened? What happened? Usman, he says, well, salat is the best deed of a believer, you know. So when people do good deeds, do the same as they do. Okay. Avoid the bad deeds. As Zuhri, he said, in our opinion, one should not offer salat behind a effeminate person unless there is no alternative. So look at those hypocrites. They are saying that a gay who is praying in front of them is tempting them. This means you must be a gay yourself. Because how a man, if he bend over, he tempt you, unless you are a guy who like men. Correct, people? How in the world you are tempted? How that can be tempting you? A man who is effeminate, as you describe him, is a homosexual. He is bending over in front of you reading the prayer, and you are getting tempted. So supposedly, they are saying, the guy is bad, the guy is bad, but the fact they are. They themselves, they are the one who is homosexual, not the guy in front of them. Maybe he is, but obviously you will not get tempted unless you are, you like it. So their stories is a stupid stories, like their prophet. How in the world you get tempted by the guy? He's a man. He's a homosexual or not. How he tempt you? What he do exactly? Do you see how stupid this cult is? There is a story about a guy, he's a mujahid. You know, he said, if I know who killed Uthman, I would do boom boom to him. A guy who liked boom boom to men, he said, well, I am the one who killed Uthman. Show us what you can do. So the other Muslim, he put him down and he started doing boom boom to him. And then the guy, the other guy from underneath, he was saying, if I know that this is the punishment of King Uthman, I would love to kill him every day. I'm just trying to be polite, not to say the word exactly. You know what I'm talking about. If I know that boom boom is the punishment of killing Uthman, I would love to kill Uthman every day. This is Islam. Do we have any Muslim? All right, guys, I think we have enough for today. Today we make it in different times, so those who live in Europe, they can join us and they can listen, because they were complaining that this is a time where they will be sleeping. So now you have no excuse. But now it's your duty, those who live in Europe, to bring me Abdul from Europe, so they will call me. As you see, we are short of Abdul, all right? The only one who wanna debate me, and obviously I'm scared of him, is this kid who his name, Why We Do Exist. Come on, debate me, scared to debate me, a real Muslim. I will give you one more call just for a laugh, you know, just for comedy. Are you there?
I'm here. Hello.
Okay.
I have my camera on the side, as you can see.
All right, no
problem. I have
problem.
This mask. You should be afraid.
No, don't open your camera for me. I'm not interested. I will hang up on you if you open the camera.
Look at the mask.
Okay, I will hang up on you then.
Okay. No, 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 wait.
Okay. So now, I want to ask you, have you ever seen Shaitan he pee?
No, I've never seen Shaitan, yes.
But do he pee? Shaitan, do he pee?
Yeah, I believe that, yeah, he does.
Why you believe that he pee? What is the proof?
Well, it's because, like, there are a lot of ridiculous things in the Quran, but I believe that there's a lot of evidence for, like, Islam, like, scientific miracles, so I accept the entire
Quran.
Hold on.
Did you say there is ridiculous things in the Quran?
Huh?
Did you just say there's ridiculous things in the Quran?
Yeah, but I swear it because there's scientific miracles in it that prove that the whole thing's true.
Okay, but you just said there's ridiculous things in the Quran. Like what?
Like what you just mentioned.
Like what?
Like what you said, Shaitan pissing, the earwax. Like, it's kind of crazy, but it's like, as the scientific miracles prove Islam.
Ah, so you are saying there's stupid things in Islam, but Islam have something smart in the same time.
Yeah, sort of.
Okay.
But that still makes it true.
Oh, okay.
But why do you want to debate?
So you think Muhammad was a stupid sometime, smart sometime, maybe?
No, no, no. He was always 100% truthful. He was the prophet of Islam.
Okay, so how he say that Shaitan, he's pissed in your ears?
Well, maybe that is true. It's just we don't understand it. Maybe it's just kind of out of our understanding. Like the Trinity. You don't understand the Trinity. You don't understand Trinity.
Yeah, I understand it.
We can debate the Bible. You would never debate the Bible with me. You would get knocked out of the park.
Really? Okay, knock me out of the park.
You look, last thing. Last thing, I asked you, show me a verse in the Bible, not the Quran, in the Bible, where it says, Jesus is God, worship me, red letters, go.
Okay. Let us see.
I will repent of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay. I will show you the verse from the Quran or from the Bible. Is that okay?
No, Quran. Bible.
From the Bible and the Quran, because we have to connect. Who is the one who is the one who forgives sin?
Huh?
Who is the one who forgives sin?
Allah.
Only Allah?
Only Allah.
Okay, so Muhammad cannot forgive sin.
Muhammad can accept sin, but he does not forgive them. He gives them to Allah. He's the interceder. He intercedes for us.
All right. So the Quran says that who can forgive sin save Allah. Do you agree with that?
I do agree with that.
All right. So if we show you that Jesus forgives sin, does that mean that he is God?
Jesus forgives no sin.
It's not up to you. It's not up to me. Like, are you going to talk to me as a man or as a kid?
I am the man here. I think you are the kid because you didn't give me a verse from the Bible.
So if I give you...
Where's the Bible?
If I give you verses from the Bible, what you would do? You would accept that the Quran...
I will obey down. No. I will obey down and I'll accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior if you can prove that he is God in the Bible.
All right. But do you promise?
Promise. I promise.
Okay. All right. Let us see what the Bible says. I will put it for you in the screen. Let us see. This is Matthew. Matthew chapter 9, verse from 1 to 8.
Yes. Okay. Because I know more about the Bible than the Quran because I used to be a Christian.
Oh, you used to be a Christian. Yeah, I believe you.
Yes. Okay. Let me read. So all through it, the entire thing.
So tell me, what is says there?
And he entered the ship, passed over into the city, and behold, they brought a man sick of palsy, lying, and Jesus, seeing their faith unto them, Son, be of good cheer, thy sins be forgiven thee. And behold, the certain scribes say, he blasphemed.
Stop. Did you just say that Jesus said to the man, your sin is forgiven?
Yes, but Allah is forgiving them through Jesus.
No, where it says that Allah said, did he say your sin is forgiven? He forgive his sin?
Yes, but he said the Father is greater than I. So the Father, he is interceding for him. He's saying that your sins are forgiven.
Okay,
and
where it says what you are saying, where you are getting this?
I will give you the verse.
Where it says that the Father forgives your sins.
And when you are praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive them, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you your sins.
All right. So now, so who is the Father?
The Father is Allah.
Is Allah. Did Jesus say, me and the Father is one?
That's corrupted.
Huh? But you just said to me, show me from the Bible.
Yes, but some parts, the parts that agree with the Quran are true. The parts that don't agree are corrupted.
Ah, okay. Okay. Let us correct the other one. So now I just showed you that when the Father forgive, Jesus, he forgive. If we go to Luke, as long as you said you know the Bible, Luke chapter 7.
Yeah.
Go there.
Luke chapter 7.
Chapter 7, verse
number. Yeah, I'm on Luke chapter 7.
Read it from verse number 5, like 45, 45, 46, 47, 48. Go ahead.
Okay, all right. You did not give me a kiss, but this woman, from the time I entered, has not stopped kissing my feet. You did not put oil on my head, but she has poured perfume on my feet. Mm-hmm. Therefore, I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, mm-hmm. as her great love has been shown. Mm-hmm. But whoever has been forgiven, these little ones loves little. Hmm. Then Jesus said to her, your sins are forgiven. The other guest said,
stop.
Who is this who forgives sins?
Okay. Who is this who can forgive sins? What do you say?
I think Allah is using Jesus through him. And he's...
Allah
right.
is using Jesus. Uh-huh.
Correct.
All right.
He gave him the authority to forgive sins.
But
Allah gave him the authority
to forgive
sins.
But you see, you promised me if I show you that Jesus say he's God and we agree that
show me God. Just because he forgiving sins doesn't make you God.
We agreed. Let us speak as a, if you want to speak like a kid, I will hang up on you. You said to me, if I show you that Jesus is God and I ask you, who is the one who forgives sin? You said only Allah. Right? Then I showed you another verse and the verse saying that the Father forgive your sin, and I ask you, who is the Father? You said God. Okay. And then I said to you that Jesus says, me and the Father is one. And then we showed you a verse, Jesus saying to the woman, go and your sin is forgiven. So only the Father can forgive sin. You
right.
said, this is God, correct?
Correct, yeah.
Okay. And Jesus said to the woman, your sin is forgiven. Did Jesus say, may your sin forgiven? Or he said to her, girl, go and your sin is forgiven.
Right.
So what right?
So
Jesus, he forgave
her
sins.
It's corrupted. It's corrupted, though.
It's corrupted. Ah, okay. So you are a hypocrite. You are a potato. You promise me if I show you in a clear evidence that Jesus is God.
Okay. No. One verse.
Only,
just give me a verse that says I'm God.
No, the verse is in the front of you. I can give you many. Chapter 3, verse 135 in the Quran says, who forgives sin save Allah only? Does it say that in the Quran?
Yeah, true.
Okay,
true.
And the verse I showed you, it says, Jesus said, go and your sin is forgiven, correct?
Yeah.
Does it say that may God forgive you?
No.
Does the Jew say to him, who is the one who forgives sin?
Yeah.
Which means only God can forgive sin, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so how Jesus forgives sin? Explain to me, go ahead.
Jesus maybe was temporarily God. Like he was God for like maybe the time on earth. But then he was no longer God.
Okay. So Jesus was temporarily God for maybe that day. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Now correct. You said you will bow down and pray to Jesus if I prove to you that Jesus is God. Because you
he's not God anymore though.
No,
He was God.
He was God.
No longer.
But still you said to me, if you can show me one verse in the Bible saying that Jesus is God, you will bow down, but pray to Jesus. Go ahead, do it. Open the camera. I will put on your screen.
Okay.
Open your camera.
Okay. All right, you win.
You win. Oh, okay. So I
will... All right. Father God, I come unto you in the name of Jesus Christ to ask for forgiveness in Jesus' name.
Okay. Oh, well, hold on. No, nobody saw you bowing down. Just hold on. Let me put you in the camera so everybody can see you. Go ahead. Bow down again to Jesus.
Okay. Father God, I come down to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and I ask for your forgiveness. In Jesus' name, amen.
Okay. Thank you very much. Well, that's it. You left Islam, and now you became a Christian. Good to have you, my friend. Thank you. All right, that was fun. He's funny, what we can say, you know. Anyway. what you can do. Yeah, can you show me where Jesus is God? I got Jesus is God temporarily now. What does that mean? You know, is it a God or is it not God? Only God can forgive sin. The Quran confirmed that. So when the Muslim they say to you, show me where Jesus says I'm God, you know, I mean, there is no honesty here. Right? There's no honesty. In the challenge, there's no honesty. Who is the one who can forgive sin? Did Jesus say, I don't forgive sin? No, you know, don't take me wrong. No. So when the Quran confirmed that nobody forgives sin save Allah, and then we find that the Messiah, he confirmed that he is the one who saved people from their sin, and even the people right away, they question, who is the one who can, you know, forgive sin? Who is the one who can do that? He said to her, go in peace. Your sin is forgiven. That's it. Who is this that forgive sin also? Also. So my friends, we have millions of reasons to believe in Jesus as God. And we use the yellow pages of Muhammad to prove our point, not because we believe in the Quran, but because the Quran is what you believe in. So we show you in from what you believe in the reasoning. Otherwise, we do not need the Quran. Quran is just a stupid book. Anyway, so today we have two people left Islam. Thank you, Lord. And we pray that our mission will be doing better and better and better. And please, if you know a Muslim sheikh who claimed that to have knowledge, there's no need to say face to face and all this madness, because obviously if you say that, you are trying to avoid debating me. You can call me. We will have a nice conversation. People do not need to see your face, neither my face. You know, there's no need for that. But people who make it face to face is just seeking excuse, so the debate will never happen. Actually, we can even call it a nice conversation, not a debate. All right. So if we can find a Muslim, if you can find a Muslim, if you know a Muslim who is willing to do so, please let him contact us, and I will be happy to talk to you, to see what you know, what you believe in, how much you know, how much smart you are, how much educated. You never know, maybe you will make me convert to Islam. Don't forget to leave a comment if you are a Muslim. And if you are a Muslim who can challenge me, don't forget to call me. As you see, we go live, waiting for your call. It's a challenge, friendly challenge. Can you make it? Do it then, so Allah can give you extra versions.